Hey, wanna feel really old? iPhone 10 was announced 2 days ago. Hey, what is up guys, I'm KBHD here, and iPhone 10 doesn't come out until November, a full month or two after iPhone 8 will come out in September. And Apple did this on purpose. They're getting two different news cycles out of two different new iPhones, and they'll probably limit supply like they usually do. You know how Apple is, but that just means that all the info that we have about the purchase decision for this phone is just in the presentation we got on stage and the hands-on time we got with it afterwards. So I condensed all my thoughts about this new phone into the first impressions video, which you should go watch. It's new. Definitely check it out if you haven't already. But from that video, it spawned a whole new sea of much more interesting questions about the phone. And these are the five most important of those. So number one, a big part of the story for this new iPhone was that they dropped Touch ID for Face ID, facial recognition to unlock your phone. And the big question is, will it be just as good? Well, first of all, the actual facial recognition technology is supposed to be really good. It shouldn't be fooled by a photo of you. It shouldn't be fooled by people who kind of look like you. It should work in the dark. A new question I've seen though is, if you actually have an identical twin that looks identical to you, will that fool it? And the answer is yeah, probably will. If your girlfriend holds your phone up to your face while you're sleeping to unlock it, will that work? No, because it won't work when your eyes are closed. You have to open your eyes to use Face ID. So Apple's got your back there, assuming you sleep with your eyes closed. And one weird thing that people have been talking about is it looked like Face ID failed in the first ever demo that Apple gave to the public, which is what they did on stage with that new iPhone. Let's take a look at exactly what happened.
iPhone 10. Now, unlocking it is as easy as looking at it and swiping up. And you know, let's try that again. Ho, ho, ho. Let's go to backup here and get right in.
Okay, so since then, Apple has actually come out with an official explanation for what happened that they gave to 9to5Mac, which was this. People were handling the device for stage demo ahead of time and didn't realize Face ID was trying to authenticate their face. After failing a number of times because they weren't Craig, the iPhone did what it was supposed to do, which was require his passcode. In other words, Face ID worked as it was designed to. So that makes perfect sense. You know how if you try the wrong fingerprint enough times in a row, it will ask you for your password if you do it like, I don't know, 8, 10 times in a row. It stops listening to the fingerprint and just says, put in your PIN. Well, apparently it's the same thing if you try the wrong face too many times in a row. So to me, that just raises a question. If people just look at your phone randomly, is that gonna count as a failed unlock attempt? Like, will there just be tons, maybe hundreds of failed unlock attempts if you just leave your phone on a table for too long and people walk by and look at it? Does that count? Are we all gonna be like Craig? Samsung kind of doesn't have this problem because when you raise the phone, it doesn't wake up. Once you hit the power button, then it starts looking for your iris and it wakes. With the iPhone, you have raise to wake. So as soon as you raise it up, it's awake and looking for a face. Could it drain battery? Could it constantly be looking for the wrong faces? Will we constantly be putting in our passcodes? That I don't know. Basically, I'm just hoping that Face ID has been worked on enough and refined enough that this won't be a problem because that's why Apple took so long to implement it. So number two is reachability and overall one-handedness. This is actually a really big overlooked part of the iPhone 10. In my original video, I didn't mention it that much, but something you might not notice is this is actually not a really easy one-handed phone. When you compare it to the current iPhone 7 Plus or 8 Plus, it has a smaller body, yes, but it's still a larger display, which means you will have to reach further no matter how small the bezels are. What made me notice this was having the home button or the home swipe all the way at the bottom and the control center all the way up at the top. Now, as someone who uses control center a lot, that is a serious stretch. And I have big hands, so I know right away from there that means it's gonna be a two-handed thing for a lot of people. I didn't get to mention that in my original impressions video, but obviously looking back at the clips, you can tell even with big hands, it's not easy. So that's something a lot of people will be using this device with two hands. So number three, is anything about this phone actually new? No, I mean, pretty much every single new feature we saw demoed on stage or highlighted or headlined about the iPhone 10, we've seen it before in some other phone. The bezel-less display with a notch at the top, well, the Essential phone literally just did that, but many other phones have been bezel-less over the past couple of years in their own ways. Qi wireless charging, this has been around for a while as well. Just last year, Galaxy Note 8, Galaxy S8, LG V30 have all had wireless charging plus many others. Face unlock, that was a key new feature back in the days of Android 4.0. Plus the Note 7 came out last year with iris scanning. Even augmented reality, there have been entire phones built around that experience. But the fact is, that doesn't really matter. I mean, you've heard this before, Apple is never really first to things, but they tend to lag behind, and then when it's well established, they leap in and do it really well, and it's well refined. That's what we're crossing our fingers for with Face Unlock. That's what we're used to seeing with other Apple features. That's what's happening again here. And to be fair, I don't really know how they can say their wireless charging is better than others, but I am really glad that it's finally here. So number four, this is a $1,000 phone. Is this thing gonna be worth the extra money? Well, that depends on you. That's also a question I've been getting about the Galaxy Note 8, the phone I'm reviewing right now. It's about $1,000. The question is always, is it worth the extra money over its closely related brother phone? But really, I think the better question is, iPhone X, what does it do for $1,000 that the cheaper new iPhone 8 doesn't do? So first of all, it's an OLED display, so it'll have a higher contrast ratio, more saturated colors, pitch black blacks. It supports HDR now. It's just overall going to look better. It's also a higher resolution. It's 2436 by 1125 at 458 pixels per inch. And you also now get to say you have a Super Retina display. And then of course the display is full screen, edge to edge, much smaller bezels, no chin. You also have optically stabilized both cameras instead of just one. So the telephoto lens should have much better performance in low light, much better video stabilization, etc. But then everything else is exactly the same. The specs, the performance, the IP67 rating, wireless charging, Bluetooth 5.0, the selfie camera, all that stuff is the same on both. So what I'd say is you have to decide if that premium design and the full screen OLED display are worth it to you. And you might be surprised how many people say yes. People, we just want the best possible iPhone. So the number five is the little stuff, just a bunch of random little nagging questions. Like, how do you take a screenshot if there's no home button anymore? Well, I didn't get to try this at the event, but I'm guessing it'll move to do it exactly the same way Android does, which is power button and one of the volume buttons. And if Siri is triggered by a long press of the power button, then how do you turn the phone off? That's usually a long press. Probably just a much longer press of the power button. So Siri is like a 2 second hold down to trigger it, but actually holding it for 5 to 8 seconds will get you that shutdown animation. Will having Face ID as your unlock prevent you from being able to just like sneak your phone in class or like sneak use it during meetings? Yes, but also you could just use your passcode like before. And we all know the space gray version of this thing will be a fingerprint magnet, but will a case or a skin on the back of this phone interrupt wireless charging? The answer is no. So skins are really thin, no problem. You can put it on the pad, it'll still work. And Qi wireless charging, I've seen on many other phones, people have used some pretty thick rubber cases and put them on wireless charging pads and they still work. So it'll depend on the thickness of the case you choose, but ideally you can try it in an Apple store and see for yourself. So there you have it, guys. I think the bottom line for iPhone X is this is really one of those phones where you'll want to wait to see the reviews before you buy. I mean, it's already more expensive than the iPhone 8, and it's coming out a little bit after the iPhone 8 as well. So you'll have, if you have that luxury of being able to wait to see if this is the phone you want to buy, do that, watch the reviews, then you'll know. It is a really beautiful phone at first glance, and in the hand, it'll probably be awesome, but obviously looking at it and actually spending your money on it are two completely different things. So that's what I hope to help you with these videos. But that's pretty much it. Feel free to share this one with anyone who you think might want to know more about the iPhone X, and of course the impressions video, which I'll link above or right below the like button. But that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. Talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.